Supreme Master Ching Hai's lectures are not a complete meditation instruction. Please do not try alone. For free of charge guidance, please visit www.godsdirectcontact.org or contact any of our centers near you.
El episodio de hoy será presentado en inglés con subtítulos en árabe, aulacense, también conocido como vietnamita, búlgaro, chino, checo, inglés, francés, alemán, hindi, húngaro, indonesio, japonés, coreano, malayo, mongol, persa, polaco, portugués, rumano, ruso, español y tailandés. Alegres saludos, televidentes de mente abierta. Mi nombre es María del Milagro, desde Zarcero, en la generosa Costa Rica. Costa Rica, ¿qué significa Costa Rica en español? Es conocida como la joya de América Central. Esta pacífica nación fue el primer país del mundo en abolir su ejército. Una república democrática con una fuerte constitución es considerada uno de los países más estables de Centroamérica. Los recursos de Costa Rica incluyen suelos fértiles, abundantes lluvias y bosques que contienen ricas plantaciones de ébano, balsa, caoba y cedro. Así como más del 25% de Costa Rica se compone de bosques protegidos y reservas. Más de 1.300 especies de orquídeas se encuentran en este hermoso y exuberante país. La vida silvestre es abundante e incluye pumas, jaguares, ciervos, monos y aves, entre las cuales están el quetzal, el guacamayo y el tucán. Célebre por su belleza natural y sus cordiales habitantes, Costa Rica ha estado implementando activamente políticas que respetan el medio ambiente. Estamos encantados de compartir con ustedes un vistazo de la belleza de Costa Rica. Deseamos que sus días se llenen con la sabiduría divina y la gracia celestial. Hoy compartimos con ustedes la tercera parte del programa titulado Estamos en la senda de los milagros. Durante más de 3 décadas, la Maestra Suprema Ching Hai ha iluminado nuestro mundo con sus enseñanzas divinas. Una maestra totalmente iluminada imparte el método Quan Yin de meditación a aquellos que desean descubrir inmediatamente la naturaleza de Dios interna y alcanzar en una vida la liberación eterna del ciclo de la transmigración. El método Quan Yin ha sido practicado por todos los maestros iluminados, tales como Buda, Jesucristo, el profeta Mahoma, la paz sea con él, y Guru Nanak. Ella enfatiza que si siempre recordamos a Dios, ofrecemos servicio desinteresado a otros y seguimos las leyes del universo, alcanzaremos nuestro potencial más elevado como humanos y comprenderemos verdaderamente nuestro propósito en la Tierra. La Maestra Suprema Ching Hai es un extraordinario ejemplo viviente de compasión, enviando frecuentemente asistencia material y financiera, además de amor a los refugiados, a los desamparados, a las víctimas de desastres naturales y a otros que necesitan ayuda. En el 2006 recibió el Premio Gusi de la Paz considerado el Premio Nobel de la Paz de Oriente, y ha sido honrada a través de los años con otros numerosos premios y galardones por sus excepcionales obras filantrópicas y humanitarias. Una verdadera voz para nuestros preciosos amigos animales. Ella promueve la pacífica y amorosa dieta a base de plantas y prevé, con el despertar de la humanidad hacia lo sagrado de todas las vidas, un tranquilo y glorioso mundo completamente vegano, donde los animales y las personas vivan en dichosa armonía. Sus iniciativas para difundir la tendencia vegana son diversas y han incluido la distribución del volante de vida alternativa, la cadena internacional de restaurantes veganos Loving Hut, Supreme Master Television, además de hablar regularmente con influyentes líderes de gobierno y medios de comunicación y participar en conferencias televisadas sobre el cambio climático, tanto si somos conscientes de ello como si no. Sus esfuerzos han tenido una enorme influencia sobre la conciencia mundial del estilo de vida amigable con los animales y de cómo esta benévola forma de ser puede traer paz duradera entre las naciones y a la vez que salvamos nuestro planeta del cambio climático. A lo largo de los años, la maestra suprema Ching Hai ha viajado por todo el mundo, desde las Américas hasta África, desde Europa hasta Oceanía, y ha ofrecido cientos de discursos al público y a sus discípulos sobre una variedad de temas espirituales. Hoy somos bendecidos con la presentación de una de estas reveladoras conferencias titulada Estamos en la senda de los milagros, parte 3 de 4, en Entre la maestra y los discípulos, dada en inglés el 26 de marzo de 2012 en Francia.
How come you get so skinny? Something wrong? Oh, it's the same.
No, no.
You lost weight?
A little bit.
Why?
Changing my diet.
Breatharian? Raw? Huh?
Fruitarian.
Fruitarian, why? Okay, whatever you're comfortable, okay? Yeah. Whatever you're comfortable. Mm-hmm. Good. And you're okay with that? Okay with fruits?
I feel really light and...
Of course. If it tastes good.
And I do eat sometimes, you know, with my family and juice.
Mm, okay. Just but mostly stuff. Fruit. Okay, understand.
Mainly fruits and juices, yeah.
Ah, good. Good for you. Any other fruitarian, watarian, fruitarians? Yeah? Yeah, you are? It's okay. You eat what you're comfortable with, okay? And if you see it's not well with your body, then you have to change, huh? Mm.
Greeting from Formosa.
Oh.
Master.
Wow.
Recently...
Sounds cool. Yeah. Recently, what happened?
Just an incident to make the sales of the meat, like pork, beef and chicken or duck drop almost 50%.
Wow, in Taiwan?
Yes.
Wow.
Or the start because the debating of the open import American beef to uh-huh. Formosa and uh-huh. and the citizen didn't like it and they speak out their voice and also the instance because the bird food and affect the chicken farm, so the consumer didn't like it. Their family, kids take intact this kind of poison food.
Correct.
So all the market sales like pork, beef, and chicken all kinds drop dramatically.
Wow!
And the sales of the even the vegetarian instant noodles sky high rock.
Oh!
Than everything else.
Wow!
It's incredible.
Congratulations! No wonder you can go to England and stay 6 months.
Yeah,
everything changed. Yeah, good.
And yeah. even better is the before some of the elementary school, the principal or the administrative tried to promote vegetarian meal provided once a week.
Okay.
And some of the parents against it objected and because the concern of their
health.
But recently the principal of those school, they practice this for a while, they feel this almost the evidence to continues because all the parents become so supportive, even they ask for it.
Mm-hmm.
And they plan to extend it from like 1 day to 2 days, even more.
Yeah.
And the parents no longer against
object.
It.
Yeah, oh, object. Wonderful.
And before there's a lot of leftover for the like vegetarian lunch because the kids they don't feel
not used to not vegetarian used to food.
And this is a lot wasted after the lunch time. Mm. But now they almost eat everything. They enjoy. They like the vegetarian meal.
Okay, more. Good. They have to cook well. You know, have yes, to cook too. Tasty meal.
Yeah, looks like good. They improve a lot and know how to. And attracted the young kids to eat.
Very good. Thanks to all you Taiwanese people working hard to spread.
It's all because Master
veganism.
Blessing. Yeah, Master power.
Yeah, but I need you guys to do it. Okay, to spread it out. Yes, you have to do it with love. Yeah, then it works.
That's true.
Yes, thanks, to do it with passion. Yes, not just because Master say it, but you have to feel it. You have to know it is really working. You must do it. Yeah, and really want to help others, yeah, and save the animals suffering, save the planet. You have to do it with your heart. Then it works for sure. It's working well. Thank
it's working
you.
Well, I think, Master, we feel that's a change, the atmosphere change, the surrounding area change, the concept of the people's change.
Mm. Also, they watch Remaster Television.
That's
before,
true.
Everywhere in Taiwan, there's Remaster Television.
That's true, in the station, your station.
Yeah, very good, very good.
And another instance is the even recently, the county, Miaoli County, they came to Sihu Center.
Mm.
They would like to kind of see what can they do to make a nice looking, like the street market outside our city center.
Uh-huh.
They want to make like an all organic farm, like farm
the
market.
Government?
Yeah, they came to investigate.
Oh.
And they just come to stop by and not notice, and we would come out of surprise.
Oh,
and
very good.
To come to greet them. And they, we wonder what they come for. But actually, they came very nicely and very
want to support our idea.
Yes,
very good.
From their Department of the Agriculture and the Tourism Department, the purpose is kind of help the organic farmer in their county.
Wow. Good government.
And provide some opportunity to continue their
surviving. Yeah, very good.
And they know we are all vegetarian, vegan, so they can utilize the market
very good.
As well. So
okay.
It looks like it's a good trend.
Good
Master.
Idea.
Thanks, Master.
Good trend, yeah, correct. Okay, any more good news? Here, so many good news. Good news.
In the U.S., like they reported in 2011, the consumption of meat and poultry decreased by 12%.
Oh, that's a lot for America because they're meat eaters, yes. 12%. Maybe it's about 24% now, eh? Who knows? Check it out, okay.
And also the First Lady, Michelle Obama,
uh-huh.
She was really trying to promote vegetarianism.
Yeah.
One time, Jay Leno is a very famous comedian.
Mm-hmm.
And she had a late night show. He invited First Lady on the show.
Mm-hmm.
And First Lady Michelle Obama brought a vegetarian pizza to him to taste.
Oh, I see.
Because he never eat vegetarian food before.
Uh-huh.
And she told him he should set example
to
encourage other people to eat
vegetarian
food.
Yeah, very nice. Oh, lovely. Yes. When they were in Brazil, they asked them to cook vegan food for them, the Obama's family. Yeah, it was on the news, yes. Long time ago, yes. And now even CNN broadcast, all the vegan research, yes, and stuff. All the television also trying where put more and more vegan stuff in now, more and more save the planet. Eat less meat and stuff, yes.
And they say, according to Harvard University research, if you eat one chicha, one serving of meat a day, you shorten your life. So if you're supposed to live 100 years, you cut off years of your life. Isn't that worth it? No, not worth it, is it? Okay, see, so even then, I teach you everything good. Even not spiritual, at least veganness lengthen your life, okay?
Some of the diseases related to meat consumption and or production.
Fatal prion diseases transmissible through air or milk. Rabies, anthrax, sleeping sickness, Q fever, norovirus, swine flu, Ebola Reston virus.
Cured meats and fish increase leukemia risk in children.
Antibiotic-resistant superbug infections and other dangerous bacteria strains.
Blue tongue disease, E. coli, Salmonella.
Bird flu, mad cow disease or Creutzfeldt-Jakob disease, 90% of the population at risk.
Pig's disease or PMWS, listeriosis, shellfish poisoning, pre-eclampsia, Campylobacter, Clostridium difficile.
Diseases hidden in healthy-appearing livestock.
Food poisoning, heart attack, kidney failure from toxic additives like melamine and clenbuterol.
Some of the costs of meat eating.
Infertility. Eating just one serving of meat per day increases the risk of women's infertility by 32%, with additional meat consumption increasing the risk.
Heart disease. Over 17 million lives lost globally each year. Cost of cardiovascular disease is at least $1 trillion a year.
Cancer.
Increased childhood cancers and adult reproductive cancers from hormones in meat.
Colon rectal cancer. Over 1 million new colon cancer patients diagnosed each year. More than 600,000 colon cancer-related mortalities annually. In the United States alone, colon cancer treatment costs about $6.5 billion. Millions of people are newly diagnosed with other meat-related cancers every year.
Diabetes.
347 million people are affected worldwide.
An estimated $174 billion spent each year on treatment in just the United States. Obesity. Worldwide, 1.6 billion adults are overweight, with 400 million more who are obese. Costs $93 billion each year for medical expenses in the United States alone. At least 2.6 million people die annually from problems related to being overweight or obese.
Environmental. Use up to 70% of clean water. Pollute most of the water bodies. Deforest the lungs of the earth. Uses up to 43% of the world's cereal. Uses up to 85% of the world's soy. Cause world hunger and wars. 80% cause of global warming. Plus more.
Some of the costs of milk consumption. Cowpox from milking cows. Bacterial microbes, pesticides, and enzymes found in cheese derived from the inner stomach linings of other animals. Up to 80% of the calories in cheese are from pure fat.
Breast, prostate, and testicular cancer from hormones present in milk. Listeria and Crohn's disease. Hormones and saturated fat lead to osteoporosis, obesity, diabetes, and heart disease, linked to higher incidences of multiple sclerosis, classified as a major allergen, lactose intolerance, plus more.
For help quitting, please visit. For more urgent information, please visit www.suprememastertv.com/killers.
Hey, Master.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm good. You can see, pretty and good. I'm pretty good. And you?
I'm fine.
You're good.
Thank you for your blessing and your guidance.
Good.
I'd like to share some good news from Florida.
Florida? Yeah, tell me. Tell us.
I have been working at Love and Not for the last 3 years.
Mm-hmm.
And besides selling the food at the restaurant, we also offer the cooking class.
They have Love and Hood in Florida, and you work there?
Yes, I work there. I coordinating the one in Orlando.
Okay.
So besides as you having the food at the restaurant, we also offer the cooking class.
Cooking class. Yeah.
And the first class was about 21 people attend the class.
How many?
21.
21.
And wow. The next class is about 100 people.
Wow. And next one will be more.
Then what happened? We have no room in our restaurant. So the church nearby offered us a place. we can handle the glass.
Okay. Yeah. Cool.
So the Assembly Adventist Church, they offer us a place. We come there and do cooking class.
Very good.
We offer about like three recipes in about 2 hours. We show SMTV, we show your lecture over there for about like 15 minutes and tell the people about why we should become a vegan. And we share the recipe. And because too many people, we cannot talk normally. We have to have with the audio equipment. We have to have the video projectors and project what we cook on the table. And we offer the free meal at the end. And sometimes they say, can I take the meal for my family, for my wife, my children? So we pay roughly about 150, 200 portions at the end of the class.
Yeah, very good.
And later on they say, where can I buy the food? The TVP, the dry food. So I say, how about you come to Loving Hut? So what happened after that is we have a section at Loving Hut with the dry food, the TVP, the quinoa, put aside there. People come and buy them.
So also tofu, homemade tofu or commercial tofu?
Yeah. So many people come back and say because of the thing they buy from us, they are able to make the cooking the vegan food at home and become
course.
A vegan themselves.
Yeah, otherwise how, hey? Very good idea, good idea. But many Loving Hut should do that also. I mean, should sell stuff so that people can cook at home.
That's why I wanted to share. And we take further step. We also bring the Loving Hut to the farmer market.
Farmer market.
So the farmer market is for people, for the farmer to come there, then sell their produce, like vegetables. So we set a tent there and we set the Loving Hut sign. People are so happy to come to us.
Yeah, of course. They have nothing to eat.
Because they know that the food is vegan.
Yeah, it's good.
So,
yeah, very good idea. Yeah, you have to bring it out also, you know, to floor market, open market. Because even for me, when I love those open market, you know, flea market, but they also sell like hot dog or stuff there, but never can find anything to eat because they're not vegan. So why don't we just do that also, okay? You know, like a flea market, they go once a week in different places. Every day they go different places. If you cannot open a big vegan restaurant, Loving Hut, you make a Loving Flea Caravan. flea market, yeah.
It's very good too, for example, the market open for 3 hours in a week, from 4 to 7. And 1 day we sell is one equal to 1 day sell a Loving Hut.
Oh, same, you see? Yes, if I don't have you, I would go out and go to flea market. Yeah, you will earn some money because you don't have any capital to lose. Okay?
We pay only $10 a day.
Yes, yes.
The overhead is very low.
And you don't have to have a big meal, big menus. Even hot dogs with curry we do. Or some vegan hamburger sandwich, something that it sells. Something that tasty, that people come and grab and go and eat. Because I love flea markets, but I can never find anything to eat there. Sometimes they have something like maybe, you know, beignet something, you know, like a fry. Look like donut, but nothing inside, eh? Just sweet and... I know, this is the only thing that can eat for vegan. You can even do that. It's very cheap, you know? You don't make donut. You just make the flour with the... yeast, yeah, and sugar, and you fry it, or some put some castor sugar on it. Powder, huh?
Cinnamon powder,
or just castor sugar, yes. Then also, or just fry apple with the flour you make to coat it, something like that, huh?
Butter.
Yeah, butter, yes. You know, very simple. You have hot dog. And you have butter and all those donut, you know, and it's enough, and you don't have to have a lot of capital. And every day you go different places, just like everybody else. And I'm sure you never lose your capital. Why don't you do that? Or even if you have Loving Hut already, you go out do that also. Yeah. By the way, ask some disciple, some your brother and sister, do this part. Yeah.
Master, and more than that, he is a beauty. So we about 3 hours for the market, and we noticed we could come there 2 hours before the market opened.
Oh, really?
So the workers at the library, at the clock house, can come to buy the food from us.
Yeah.
The vendor, because they're busy at from 4 to 7, they come to us to buy the food first. So
wow.
Many vendors come to us before they open the market.
Understand. See, look at that.
Master. And here's more thing. And
another beauty.
At the end of that, they come to us to pack some food home.
Oh, wow, look at that.
And we remember you told us we had to cook the food very good.
Yes.
The price has been reasonable.
Yes.
And also we add one more thing called abundant.
Yes.
And what we do here, we have some kind of rice combo, the
yeah.
noodle combos.
Mm-hmm.
So you can choose the rice, the base, noodle,
mm-hmm.
the base. They can
yes.
have like three items.
Yes.
And they can add on top of that.
Yes.
And sometimes we sell for $8 a combo.
Uh-huh.
And then somebody comes and say, I have $1.47. What can I buy?
Uh-huh.
I say, you can buy a lot. Please select what you like,
uh-huh.
and you pay what you can.
Oh, that's nice.
And I like it a lot. And sometimes they come and they're hungry, and they tell them, are you hungry? They say, yes. Say, I double the things for you.
Oh,
they give them the double the rice, double noodle, double the food.
These are not very expensive to make.
They are not, yes. because we can make like gluten, for example. It's very simple to make.
Yes.
And I make them, and
if you make at home, it's cheaper even, yes.
Yes. And what happened also is the organic farmers come to us and say, at the end they have some vegetable left. They say, can I trade my vegetable with the food?
Sure.
Yes,
oh,
yes,
that's cute. That's cute. Yeah, of course, of
yeah.
course.
So now we trade with them. We trade the vegan food with the vegetables.
yeah.
But sometimes they come with nothing. They have nothing left.
Uh-huh.
I say, we still trade with you. Take some food home with
you. Okay, why not? Okay.
And at the end of that also is the homeless also come to us at the market.
And you give them leftover, whatever, yeah?
At the beginning, we have leftover, but then
you cook more, right?
There were many people, so
uh-huh.
we cannot predict how many people.
Mm-hmm.
So we cook extra thing for them, we set aside for them.
Uh-huh.
And
wow.
they can I have some meat? They like the gluten, they
uh-huh.
set them.
Uh-huh.
And we tell them it's not meat, it's like gluten, it's
but
not
it tastes good,
products.
Okay,
tastes
very
good.
Ah, that's good. I like it. I love this. If I could cook for people like that, I would be very, very happy.
And
yes.
I'm very good cook. My wife cook very well.
Never mind, yeah. Even if you're not, you can learn. You can go to Loving Hood and learn with the Vietnamese real good cook. You know, there are many of them who can cook very well. You can learn with them. One thing, you can buy this ready-made gluten flour, okay? Gluten powder, and add a little bit more other flour so that it softens, because if we just use a gluten flour, then it's too hard, okay?
Mm. I use the gluten flour, and I put in there like seasoning, salt, and sugar.
Mm-hmm.
I can make about 100 portions for about like 10 minutes.
Mm-hmm. See.
I steam them.
You make it yourself or the gluten first?
I put in the flour,
uh-huh.
and I put using the KitchenAid blender to mix them.
Mm-hmm.
And I use the aluminum foil and roll them into a roll like and steam them. It's so excellent.
I know. Just it's even like that, it's nice. No need to even anything yet, you know? Just like that. Just steam or boil it, yes.
And what happened is the line for the food get longer and longer. And some of the cook at the nearby, they come and see us, how we can sell the vegan food.
oh, really?
And they also say, can you bring some food for me to my restaurant?
Mm-hmm.
So I bring some of the vegan food to the restaurant, the meat restaurant,
uh-huh.
and sell them there.
Okay, wow.
And
also teach them how.
Yes, we do. They will have some event
mm-hmm.
that we can come and cook at the restaurant also.
Yeah. Tell them if they want to turn their restaurant to vegan, we're willing to teach them everything.
We try.
Yes.
And also the nearby university, they also invite us to come there to offer the vegan food to the students.
Oh, wonderful.
And they say, I have no manpower. I say, no problem. They offer the students to help me.
To help you. Wow.
So in the morning, they come and carry the food with me.
Yes.
And we just serve the food to the students. And if they can donate, so-called, they contribute to the cost of the food,
mm-hmm.
they can. Otherwise, okay, it's free.
Oh, wonderful. Are you a rich man? You can do that.
I'm very rich. I'm very rich right now. But thank you for your guidance. And I'm very happy to share the information.
Yeah, it's good. You have to be more creative like him. See? Don't just sit there and wait for customer. Go out and get them. Go and get them, tigers. Go get them.
and more good news.
Yes.
I found out last year the foreign government changed the law.
Yes, they do.
Normally it's very difficult to cook in U.S. because you must have a license.
Even just a car, you have to have license.
Yeah. But last year they say no license needed. If you cook baking food like the bread, candies,
uh-huh.
Cakes,
uh-huh.
Jams, cookies, for example,
uh-huh.
no
uh-huh.
license needed.
Oh.
But you have to provide the food directly to the consumer. For example, you can bring the food to the farmer market and sell them.
Uh-huh.
But you cannot sell through the internet.
Oh, I understand. Wow, that's good already. We don't need internet. We go to flea markets. Yeah? Please go to flea markets. Yeah?
Yeah.
That's where you meet all kind of varieties of people. Mm-hmm. Hmm? And then the word will spread also. You bring your loving hood cart with you and put there so people to take. And then today they eat just a sandwich or hot dog, vegan hot dog with you. Tomorrow they go to your restaurant or next days, okay?
Yeah. Hey, Fang Hon, so for example, in order for us to get to the farmer market easily, you must be a farmer or sometimes you...
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. So I bought a piece of land and will totally become a farmer.
Oh, no, you don't have to be. But in the flea market, they have all kinds. They sell clothes, they sell hot dogs, they sell shoes also. Why have to be farmer market?
Sometimes they require you a piece of paper. You must be a farmer.
Okay, good. Then be a farmer. Buy 2 square meters of land somewhere, put some vegetable on it, and...
Amables televidentes, han estado viendo Estamos en la senda de los milagros, parte 3 de 4, en Entre Maestro y Discípulos. Por favor, sigan sintonizados a Supreme Master Television. A continuación sigue del sagrado Fih Ma Fih, del sufismo Discursos de Rumi 12 y 14, parte 1 de 2. En palabras de sabiduría. Que el cielo los bendiga a ustedes y a sus seres queridos con abundante salud y felicidad. Para más detalles, por favor visiten www.suprememastertv.com/BMT.